It's really an honor to share with everyone about the Falco. And of course, we have descriptions and introductions of the Falco. And we are going to talk about the integrations between Falco and for Kubernetes audit log to do the operational testing.
不需要，成团。
那个，我想问一下，就是大家有用过Falco？
Is anybody sitting here using used Falco before?
那背景调查一下，大家有多少是 DevOps？
How many of you have done DevOps before？
那有多少是做 security 的吗？
How many of you are doing security here？
Okay, 有做 DevOps 加 security 的吗？
Anybody doing DevOps plus
security？
Okay.
所以还是 DevOps 多一点。
So more DevOps, right？
好，谢谢大家。那现在开始。Thank
you very much. So we are about to start. Let me give you a brief introduction myself. I'm Huang Kaizhe, coming from Sysdig. I'm the security researcher at Sysdig. And Falco is actually occupying the majority of my working time. So when I'm introducing you to Falco, I'm actually telling you that we are going to build up a community which is going to help everybody to better use Falco to do the operational checks. We have our official website. We also have our Slack channel. If you have any question when we are using the Falco, you can actually go to the Slack channel to ask the questions. We also have our blog and our workshop. It's something just like a tutorial, which you will adapt it and learn step by step. Because it's open source, you can also see it on GitHub, and also some of the open source documents. Falco can operate as a container.
Okay,
So apart from me, this is the members of the Falco team. They are based in Italy, in America, and if you have any questions, you will find that the people from different time zones will answer your question within 24 hours. And Falco itself is still a CNCF project in the pipeline. It's still growing, and we hope that it could develop better. For many perspectives, it needs improvements, and we can sum up here for the three parts. Information checks. If we have more information for the operations, all the checks about the operations, it would be much better. The second part is about the automations and integration. We see many different users actually take the Falco testing result as an input. And we are also using the EO key to see how many Falco robots started. Now for the third part, we call it a content. The content we are testing for the majority part is about the we need to spend a lot of time in the perform library. And there are many different nginx, or the CNCF vendor, or the Eastern linker, or the linker. It might generate some of the explorations, and we need to contribute that. That is a lot of white list, which we need to add it to the Falco. The Prometheus is actually tracking all the different steps of the Falco, and we talk about the ELK, or some of the screaming output might be helping the Helm to maintain the Falco version. So here, it's going to generate a lot of help for the growth of Falco. Because it's open source, we believe that we are going to have a shared contribution to Falco. Falco itself is error testing equipment. That is to say, if you are using Falco, you might understand that what you are expecting about the operation behavior. For example, I know that my input is operating and my processing is operating and my log is being read. So you will have the presumption that which behaviors are normal behaviors. And for Falco, it can track all the bases, which is based on the Sysdig. Sysdig is another series of a product in our company. It will provide you some of the system call level filtering to put on top of the system call. So based on all the information, system call is going to operate that. And we also going to support all the orchestrators for their integration. So for our output right now, it's going to be at the documentary level and also some of the slug level. It can be wider and expand more expanded. So if you are looking back to all of this, Falco is actually a ever testing equipment, especially for the major equipment and for the
orchestrator.
It's still a project needs to be finished. So here let's look at some core principle. So here the Falco is on the right, and we read out all the pathways for Falco. So we are going to go through these pathways one by another. The first one is that for Falco, let's check about this point. Let's wait for its relaunching. We see some of the containers operating. So this is an Excel, and this is a terminal bash, which was under operation. When I was starting to copy this ETC shadow file, you will see another event which is happening right now. And for document,
所以我们现在可以来讲一下，就是 Falco
它内部的一个架构。就刚刚提到的，就是Falco
它是基于 Sysdig
它的一个分布。所以是actually a platform based on the Sysdig。然后它都可以去不叫截取吧，就是不是去然后。然后Sysdig。就是一些就是可能就是一个
thread ID。
And this actually a 3ID agenda. These information are not enough for us to get out. In the process, it will be read inside of the internal pathway. And later, we are going to do the context enrichment. For example, I see this third ID. I will understand that this is coming from the process ID. And if I see this ID, I know that this is actually coming from Apache. Then we will check which namespace this ID belongs to. And later on, we find that if it's
subnetting,
we will understand which port it is
operating.
So we actually copied this information
to
do a decision-making procedure.
But
here,
Falco
is working like a rule engine. After the system copying
events,
we will check whether this event is matching with all the different parts. We are going to issue this report.
Binary direction 里面去写一些东西。
In the final direction of this attempt,
就是主要的这个检测的这样一个条
件，或者
说检测的这样一个核心，就是基于这个如果这些 system call event 满足这个条件呢，那事件就会被触发。然后同时之后啊，触发事件之后去呈现结果，或者说你想
，we will generate the certain results. So here in this output, let's have a check about the provision and how do we write wrote about it. And for which part can we wrote about our focal root?
好，刚刚讲到就是其实 Falco 的 root agent 就是会从那个 system call 里面。在 bin 或者是在 user bin 里面
，the bar direction would be in the bin or in the user bin。
然后这个操作是一个写的操作，然后这个写的操作是在这两个目录下面。这就是我对这个
these are the two logs。
就是说，任何的 system call，
so for any system call，
这个条件
，as long as it's meeting up with these conditions，
是
it's going to be an open condition，
并且是写在这两个目录下面。
And it's actually written up in these two different conditions。
好，那现在就是说，如果我知道有件事情是有人打开了，有人写，就是有人做一个写操作在我的这个目录下面，那我想知道是谁写的，所以我们就可以在这个啊，就是 Falco root 的 output 上面，就输出画面就可以定义这个 user 可以写啊
，user
就是这个反方号 user dot name 就知道啊，这是哪个用户啊，然后是哪个。哪一条命令在执行这个写作，然后这个 prompt.cmd line 就包括了你的这个程序的名字，还有程序的这个输入参数，
input，
然后接着就是具体是你写入哪个文件。如果大家还回去看看刚才那个操作的话，就是刚刚那个小 demo 的话，其实它是把这个ls.hack 这个文件
的 ls and doc hack
写进了。User bin 或者 bin direction，
it's being written into the bin or the bin direction。
好，所以就是这是基于一个system call system call event，
这是 actually based on the system call。
那在1.1 之后呢，然后就
after the 1.13。
There is the Kubernetes one.
Of course, we have the audit.
就是那个 Kubernetes 的 audit policy。
The Kubernetes audit pockets。
没有啊。
Do we have that?
OK， 知道 audit policy 是做什么的
okay, ？What do you? So what are we using the audit pocket for?
就简单来说，就是就是谁在什么时候做了什么事情
？Who did what?
And 就是
where？
我创建了一个
is the information we gather at the audit pocket. This is the log we created.
类似于这样子的。
And
那就是知道这些有什么用呢
？Since we are doing that.What is going to work?
想想知道这些有什么用
？What are these are going to work in ourselves?
我们可以 interact， 就我们可以互动一下，因为人比较少。
So because we don't have so many people here, can we get the interaction between each other?
可以随机续载，
可以什么？
可以随机续载，
续载
就续载，我
觉得。It can work as an overload.
其实没有，这个是没有的。对审计，对，其实 audit 的话就是审计的目的。那审计的话就是说，就是
so,
那这个记录呢就可以被包括利用，然后做检测。 好，这个就是一个简单的一个 quality event， 就是说当然它的类别就是叫 event， 然后重要的比如说你看 time stamp 什么时候发生的，
example, you know,
然后它动作是什么，是一个
delete，
对吧？然后它的 request UI， 啊，我先不看 request UI， 就是 user 是谁在操作，这是个 meaningful
piece。
那它的对象是什么？就是一个
object
啊，这是一个 namespace 的，这个叫
namespace，
namespace 的这样一个操作是一个delete namespace， 就删除 namespace 的一个操作。
namespace action。
对，然后所以的话，你不会想，就是说，哎，有人删除
namespace。Somebody delete a namespace, but you don't have a notification. This will not happen with this SR machine. When you refresh the UI, you see that the namespace is not there, and you're confused.
So, for
the Kubernetes event, it will give you those kind of information which will spare you from this confusion. So, Falco, how can I integrate Kubernetes events?
Let me go back.
Actually, for the Kubernetes, it supports Kubernetes events. You can directly write it on the file,
and
on the master node, you can define the audit log
output. 那另外的话就是另外一种叫 webhook， 就是说它会支持，就是你把所有
body
就导到另外一个就是
reload it to shift
web endpoint 上面，
web endpoint，
就相当于是一个restful request， 这样子把所有的所有的 body events 就输入到那个 endpoint。
然后
另外一个叫 body sync，body sync 是相当于是一个支持动态动态去改变你的那个 body policy 这样一个
body policy
一种机制。
This is a mechanism。
那包括它其实用的就是第二。
就是
web， 那我们会有一个就是一个就是一个 web server， 然后这个
web
server 其实不做什么事情，就是
The web server has only one job is to monitor
all the
audit events。
然后我们当然另外同时，如果你要使用这个
in the meantime if you use Kubernetes events you have to config
Kube
API server on your master node, and then you have to change
dash
dash audit config or audit location. Some parameters you need to change, and then point it to the embedded web server. And all the audit events will be transferred
to
the Falco web server.
对，就是一个 post，
so this is a postmodern audit. This is the input.
那现在的话，你会看到
and here you can see.
For Kube audit event,
for Falco, there are two information ingress. First, Kubernetes audit log, the other one is system core. So from these two layers, from system core level, it's a very foundational layer. On the other hand, it's a very overall, based on Kubernetes perspective, it's a better.information origin.
那在好，这个可以简单跳过一下，因为这个是有点 deep dive.
This is a little bit deep dive, so I'll not go very deep into this. Let's pass this slide. Well, how about let me return? Let me talk about it even more. Because Falco needs to deal with different original resources, information resources at the same time. So we need a genetic event interface.
然后就可以同时处理
and only this way can we, in this way we can process different information at the same time. The rationale behind this is that we treat different information region as JSON. event.
然后再像比如说这是一个，然后用
JSON
来对那个对它的那个就是一个值进行引用。那比如说这是一个简单的例子，比如说
as you can see here,
foo 等于一 bar 然后 bars p 然后 array 然后一三四，那就是每个用它的那个斜杠 foo 就可以取一个值一。
For the value for the slash for is 1, the slash bar slash bars is t, and then you see this is the code for the JSON pointers, and then we can have the value. So the purpose of this is that when we are doing the coding, when we are doing the condition, decoding the condition, you need to use this. For example, event type, fd.name, user.name, so all of these are JSON objects. We've just to try to pull that information.
This is a Kubernetes log,
Kubernetes audit events.This is
the
verb
response status,
and
then the object reference,
object reference,
and then the level.
On the left hand side, it is
different
JSON pointer reference method.
那就是当然就是因为 就是如果你是想使用那个追踪指针的话，就意味着你对这个追踪的这个对象有一个非常清晰的认识。
It means that you need to have very clear cut understanding about the pointer. You need to have understand the fields, the event fields. You need to understand what kind of value it generates and the return back to you. So you need to create a focal rule. It is quite difficult, but we've defined some.Macro fields or reserve.
ka.verb, which is kub audit,
it's called ka.verb.
ka.verb
tells you what kind of action it is, whether it is a delete or creation. And then ka.ura and ka.user.name, they mean that the user is doing it. ktarget means the target, the object, whether it is namespace or deployment or pod.
其实它同样的就是它只是给大家方便使用，因为它
to facilitate
就是它的那个
execution
其实都是引用那个 JSON 指针去指向那个真正的
JSON pointer to point to the actual event fields。
如果大家想知道，就是说到底。
If you really want to know, what on earth is the event fields of the Falco? You just have to input Falco slash slash list equal case and score audit. And then you see what kind of reference field, what kind of macro or event fields can be used.
All right,
so then let's look at a little bit more complex instance. It is okay because during the demo session, I will prepare you with some simple case, but this is a rather difficult one. So first, the focal room is when I want to look at config map. Within the config map, there are AWS keywords, for example, AWS access key ID, AWS S3 access key ID. So all of these keywords represent password or key that consists in this config map. Any problem with this, do you think? Are there problems with this? You think there's no problem? Okay. I think so too.
But
actually,
就是关于密码这个东西
When it comes to password,
至少可以用 Kubernetes
You need to, you at least can use Kubernetes Secret, right? Although I don't like Kubernetes Secrets also, but it is better than config map. I suggest that if you want to store any kind of password or sensitive information, you need to use Kubernetes Secret. So this is the only way to create this, and
there's
one way to create it,
and
see this is the route. There are three macros being defined,
and
the macro or the list, these are just to help you to repeat it, use it repeatedly, because for one macro it will be used for different routes.
那这个它这个就是KA 就是那个
Kubernetes
对于这一类信息的这样一个
Example, for the namespace, this is a request. All the config objects in the request,
this
contains three possibilities:
AWS SPID,
AWS REST Access KID.
你可能就是说，可能不仅仅是 update 啊，也可能是
patch，也可能是 create。
所以这个 modify 这个红呢，就相当于就是说，
for this macro modify means that any action about create, update or patch we call it modify.
所以如果再看，再看这个 Falco rule 的话，就会看到它的这个
Falco rule，
然后。 rule 的名字,
然后它的描述, the description of the rule,
condition
of the rule, what is the condition here? Condition here is that the config map and the modify and contains private credentials including all the above mentioned three macro, including some private or sensitive information.
那输出里面有什么呢？输出的话就有，就是这是一个 config map with private credentials，然后用户的用户信息，
the user equals the ka，
你的那个名字
verbs， namespace。
你会发现其实这个 output 其实不是很好，为什么呢？因为你把那个密码的内容都打出来了。
It seems that you put all the password
in output 上面
out there，
你应该
on your cloud， it is not good，
应该不应该这么做
？You don't want to do this。
好，这个就是对，然后你会看到就是这是关于 Kubernetes 的，然后它的那个你会看到它有特别有一个叫做 source 这样一个就来源的这样一个 field， 就是 case underscore audit， 默认的话就是 Syscall，the
default
默认的话是 Syscall， 我一会儿会给大家展示一下，就是两种不同类型的那个入是什么样的。好，那就我们来简单看一看这个 demo。
Look at the demo.
Cluster running. 这是我之前的一些测试。然后接下来这些就是我会运行的一些命令。然后我们会看到就是第一个就是 我创建一个 service account， 好，创建成功
，OK， create successful，
嗯，出来了，有点慢
，successfully created， sorry about it's too late， but I successfully created，
这个是第一个， 你可以看到它这个是一个，我看这个是谁创建了这个 service account， 就 user 是 bad account， 然后是在 namespace 是
default，
然后这个 decision 是，就是看到就是，就这件事情被这个事情被触发了。This
is a output event.
然后第二个我们来做另外一件事情，是cluster rule binding，然后cluster rule custom，是刚才创建的这个bad account。
我在做什么呢？我把cluster的main role，is that the main role of cluster will be given to the bad account.
好。OK。然后就另外一个就是，刚才那条是 information，previously
is about information，it's not so high level， just a service account.
那现在我就有一个 warning level， 就是说突然间有
cluster main role， 然后被 suddenly there's a cluster main role being deploy a service account. How do you think about this? You create a cluster main road and you put it into a service account. How do you think about this? Speaker is not using microphone, sorry. Okay, so for the service account, it was used to manage your own pod content, microservices.
However,
for cluster level,
need
to give it to customer or group, not the service account. So this is when the Kubernetes defined servers. They are not for manage the cluster, just manage the microservice.
Okay, next,
I create.
Create namespace. Test NS1. 对，同样的话，我也你会在这里会看到一个信息啊，你有一个namespace 创建，就是这个，这个创建的话，就是说就是你应该知道你大概有多少个 namespace 在管理，就是说其实这个你可以有一个 whitelist， 你可以有一个
namespace，
在这个就是白名单以外的这个 namespace 被创建应该有一个有一个就是有一个报警。然后我们同时也看到了，就是这个因为你创建一个创建一个 namespace 的时候，它会
因为 creating a namespace
一个 service account， 然后你会看到
it's going to create a service account
这样一个
it's going to generating alarm like this。
好，最后我们来要 apply 一个 YAML file 了。
So finally, we are going to apply a YAML file.
这 YAML file 是做什么呢
？So what do we use this YAML file for? It's like an nginx.
Privilege port.
It's like a privilege port.
它是一个就是有特权的 port， 怎么说？它是一个 privilege port。然后如果我在 apply 之后会发生什么
？If I apply it, what will happen?
好，创建了，创建成功。
So after I created it，
然后就看到 pop， 这就是一个警告 warning level 的警告。
From a warning level，
pop started in privileged container。
Pop started in privileged container。
然后同时你会看到这个一条其实是来自于 Falco 的 Falco system call 的一个
reset，
就是因为它你 privileged pop 就意味着你所有的 container 都是 privileged， 所以的话其实你是触发了两条这个
Falco
root， 一个是 Falco
root
的那个就是 privileged pop launch， 另外一个是 Falco 的这个 system call 的
root，
是 privileged container launch
root。
在这个，就是说，在这个 case 里面
，That is what happened in this case。
对，所以就是我想就是说，像这些
，What I want to say here that Kubernetes is a very complicated part。
然后它的那个，所以你需要一些足够的信息，或者说足够的
enough information，
就是信息的颗粒度，然后来做决定
，enough particle to make the safety decision。
System call level 的信息
and you need a system call level information and also the
kube
audit information to help you in different dimensions to test about the operational safety during the operation.
好啊，时间我还有多少分钟？
So
三分钟。好，谢谢大家。那个对，就是
okay, 3 minutes. Thank you very much.
这个再次就是欢迎大家就是加入我们的 Slack channel。如果有什么问题的话，就可以在上面问。
You can actually ask us the question on top of that. It's in English, but I'm also Chinese speaking. You can also add me and written it in Chinese.
就是如果有什么问题的话
，So if you have any question.
因为在那个
the major part is that
就是 Kubernetes 的
in the Kubernetes operating part，
在安全领域的 vendor，
the vendor
不是太多
，is not so many，
或者说都只
you can，
包括其实
or you could only do for one part， you need to use different attempts and different tools to integrate it with yourself and your own operational scenario。
是。
The speaker is not using the microphone, so the interpreter cannot translate.
有没有方式可以做这种回退的操作，类似于
Do you think that We have any method to do the beam lock? No, I don't have that. You are asking a Kubernetes question. So we call it Falco. Do you think if the Falco works well, it can be operated in other different logs auditing? If you got something application level log, it would be much better. It's like a DSL. To be used in other different log analyzing, right? We have discussed it before.
反应速度的问题。如果说，比如说，你可以把你所有的 log 都发到，比如说
So if you can send all of your log into the span and do a transformation and to match all the information, it would be much more slower. This is one part of our concern. Our ideal is that we provided you a general monitoring interface and you put your data and send your data to me.And then you will get your definition of data, and you can actually work another side of the Falco. And I will operate according to your Falco route. Thank you. In the future, how big is going to be about this overhead? Because we are based on the Sysdig. The biggest overhead is under the Sysdig. We need to get a system call, and it's very easy for us to match because we never do this. And for this overhead, it's less than 5%.
IO limit 的话是四 KB 每秒。
So IO limit is the 4 KB per second. I know that the CCP is getting a monitoring with us. So if I'm taking eBPF to do this monitoring, what is the benefit of that for Sysdig?
So, Sysdig monitor
is permitted.
And for the permitted,
the problem is about its scalability. But Sysdig is going to permit this to address for the CLL issue.
And
so we are attempting that we are going to generate a unified problem cell definition. And all the metrics is going to be written in a same language about this metric. Thank you. Okay, thank you very much.